This is all you need to do to get fast results in seeing some kind of movement or shift with your SP. Hey everyone, it's Kim Velez, Conscious Life and Success Coach and Licensed Mental Health Therapist. So before we jump in, if you are interested in my email coaching services, the link is in the description box below. I also have a free Facebook group as well as a paid Facebook group. The link's down there, all the info's down there as well. The paid Facebook group, info all about what we do in the group. I pop in there every week. We do challenges, rants, really fun stuff. That is in the community tab as well. And I have a manifest your specific person back and keep them online course, which the link is in the description box below as well. And today we are talking about how do you get faster results with your SP? And this is the thing is that if you, and I say, right, I'm going to say this in every fucking video because like without this concept, then you don't really understand what you're doing. And I feel like some, not that we have to understand what we're doing, but to be empowered to know what you're doing, it helps reinforce and get rid of, or helps reinforce you feeling confident and understanding that you're the operant power and the creator of your reality. And it also helps you get rid of fucking any anxiety and doubt when it creeps in. So if you understand everyone is you pushed out, then you understand when you're sitting there in your mind and you're pining over your SP and you're, you know, picturing them with a third party or whatever, arguing with them in your mind. I've been notorious for that in the past. And just focusing on not the things that you want to experience with them, they will receive that because your consciousness is your reality. So whatever you have going on in your mind about your SP, they will conform to that, right? They will think the same way about you. They will feel the same way towards you. So if you're holding in anger and resentment or sadness or, you know, they don't want me, they don't want me. Well, every time you're pining over that, you're reinforcing it in them to have to conform to that version where they don't want you. So the fastest way is to create this beautiful story in your mind and focus on that. I have seen this. I have seen this too many times, and I don't know why the fuck it took me till like a month ago for this to just click on the level that it has, but who cares? I'm here now, so I'm very happy. But I have seen this with so many people in my life, clients, YouTube subscribers, strangers, my SP, my son. Like I have just seen this with friends, with too many people in my life to literally parrot back to me exactly what I've been affirming or creating in my mind, like constantly, constantly. And even with my SP, there was a time when we were not together. It was a while ago. And I kept affirming every day, he's constantly thinking about me. He wants to contact me. And he started reaching out to me and he was telling me he missed me and he was texting me and kept asking to see me. And I kept saying no. And for 3 months he did that. And I kept saying no. And then I finally saw him. And that night he said to me, I couldn't stop thinking about you. He was like, it was like you were stuck in my mind on this mental loop. And I was sitting there laughing in my head like, holy fuck, I manifested that. And that came in really fast with him. And I've had other things as well, negative and positive for me in regards to him. But this stuff really does work. Like it's so fast. And like the fastest way to get a shift is to really keep your mental diet. And this is basically what you're going to hear from me going forward, is like breaking it down to remind you to kick your ass so that you create the reality you want. Because if everyone's you pushed out, the world is a mirror of you reflecting back to what's going on inside of you, right? It's not about changing them. It's about changing you. It's changing your viewpoint. It's changing your perspective. It's changing your story of how these people are showing up in your life. It's changing the story of you in your life. And I had a client who, she's fucking amazing and she has a long history, you know, issues in her love life and feelings of abandonment and things like that. And this is how this journey started for her. She wanted to manifest an SP back, and she was having issues at her job and was really starting to hate going to work. And she was even scared she was going to get fired. And there was just all this stuff going on at her job. And I told her, like, just change your concept of self. Like, I'm a valued employee. Like, people love me at my job, right? So she did that. She just reaffirmed all day long, I'm a valued employee, I'm a valued employee, I'm a valued employee. And within a couple days, everybody's attitude in her work started changing and they were being nicer to her. And then all this shit started happening within like a week's time behind the scenes, where people were getting fired that were not pleasant with her, and the whole structure changed. And like, she loves her job and she gets along with everyone and they praise her all of the time and she feels so confident and secure. And all she did was reaffirm anytime she had a negative thought about her job that I'm a valued employee, I'm a valued employee. So she did this with her SP. And there, it was a little bit rocky, but now it's inconsistently. And he's literally, you know, parroting back to her, her own affirmations that she's been saying to him. So now she has this new confidence in herself and feels amazing, especially with her SP, because she knows, I just have to focus on what I want with him and just reaffirm the positive thoughts and assumptions of who I want to experience, you know, like what I want to experience with him. And he's reflecting it back to her. And this is all we have to do. And the reason why it comes in faster this way is because it's your dominant thinking pattern. So you're literally changing instantaneously your consciousness. Your consciousness is your state. Your state is your reality. So you're shifting into a parallel reality where this is who you are. This is how people show up for you. This is what's going on. And you're reaffirming it. So you're reinforcing it all day long. And you're holding that as your dominant thought pattern, which that has to be reflected back to you. So it's not like one thing that you say and then, you know, you forget about it, right? And then 10 years later, it fucking manifests. Well, who's got time for that shit? I don't want to wait 10 years. And listen, I used to believe in divine timing, and I really don't think I believe in that anymore, to be honest with you, because of my own kind of shit of really understanding about law of assumption, because I think that's just what law of attraction people told us, because in the law of attraction community, it's just different. It makes you feel like something's out there that you have to like bring in, or you have to get your vibration a certain way. And over time, when you've matched that frequency, then it will come into you. And it's like everybody in that community is trying to strive and do a million techniques to get their vibration up and to hold it as long as they can, so they get this thing in. And then when it's not coming in, it's divine timing. It's that. Now, having said that, I do believe, like, because when you're creating your reality and like depending how many players are involved that need to move in your reality to have the manifestation come into fruition, it may be a little bit longer with some things, right? Like maybe a month or 2 months or 3 months rather than a day, right? But I don't think things should take years. Like, there should be movement and shifting if you're affirming it every day, because your thoughts are what create. So if your thoughts are constantly focusing on what you want, you're creating that every single day, all day long. That's what manifesting is. It isn't scheduling time to go do this or that. All those tools and techniques can help and get us in a different internal state, which is always good, because then we enter a new consciousness, which is a new reality. And they can really help calm our mind down when we feel anxious, like meditating and things like that. And you can, you know, if you quiet yourself, sometimes you can kind of get some insight into you and what's going on. But those things aren't manifesting, in my opinion. Manifesting is thinking about something over and over, because that's what we do. Like, when you were manifesting yucky stuff in your life, like, did you go schedule sats out to do that? No. Did you have to go close your eyes on the couch and visualize like you and your SP fighting? Or did you go schedule time out to visualize your SP cheating on you or breaking up with you? Did you create that whole scene in your mind and sit there and visualize it one time a day to have this breakup? No. You created the breakup because your assumptions and thoughts created the breakup, because your assumptions and thoughts said, they don't want me, I'm not good enough. And you kept reaffirming that, thinking that over and over. And then obviously, the more you think things, we create that imagery naturally in our mind. So this is what I'm saying, like, that's what manifesting is. So if it works for us in the negative way, all we have to do is just change the thinking to focus on what we want, and that will manifest. So you can, like I say in every video, you can certainly visualize, you could do meditating, do whatever the fuck feels good for you, because the point is, who wouldn't want to feel good? And if it gets you in a place where you feel more confident, like it's working, go for it. It's your reality. You create whatever you want. But I'm just saying that we don't have to do all that stuff. So that's why I particularly don't really believe in divine timing, really. I mean, I'm not 100% solidified in that. I feel like, because some things do take a little bit longer sometimes, but I think it's really more about that. It's the old consciousness that's kind of lingering. And so we just have to keep reaffirming the new consciousness so that that's the dominant, and it kind of wipes out kind of, I don't even know what the right terminology is, but I think you know what I mean. So sometimes that old consciousness is still there because we held that for so long. So as we're shifting and creating the new reality in the beginning, some of that old shit's still there, and that's okay. You just reaffirm through it, because the more you reaffirm through it, the more you're creating the new reality that you want, which will have the versions of people and experiences that you want for yourself. So I went on a side rant there. I think it's important to understand that all this shit starts shifting quick. Like, I'm telling you right now, I have seen the fastest fucking results that are consistent than I've ever seen in my life by applying this. And since I have gone through this, all the clients that I work with, I tell them to do the same fucking thing. We're all doing it together. They're in my groups. They're in all these things that I'm in, you know, communication with them. And they're all getting the same fast fucking results. And they're pumped as fuck. And they're excited because they're like, holy shit, it really is this easy. And it really fucking is. So I just wanted to share this with you, because all you have to do to get some fast movement with your SP is have more thoughts focused on what it is you want rather than thoughts focused on what you don't want. And this is anything in life, anything in life. I have been reaffirming things in my business, and within like a day, I started seeing the uptick in my YouTube. My subscribers are shooting through the roof. Like, all, and it's been, I started that on September 5th. So now I'm what, two and a half weeks? Not even 2 weeks. I'm not even 2 weeks. Well, by the time you see this video, it'll be 2 weeks. But at the time of this video, I'm not even 2 weeks into the game of focusing on things with YouTube and my business. And I started seeing instant results shoot up in a day, and it's been consistent, and it's still going because I keep reaffirming and focusing on what I want. So like, this is so easy, guys. It really fucking is. And the goal is to just stay persistent in it no matter what. So even on the days where maybe it's not a lot of movement, I just still persist in what I want and focus on what I want, and boom, it's the next day. It's so much more consistent, and it comes in faster. And the same thing is with your SP. Like, I'm seeing it with mine. And even when I don't see it with mine, I still don't give a fuck, because I know who I am. And he's only going to be the way I deem him to be, because I am the God of my reality. And what I focus on, he has to conform to. So I keep focusing on what I want to experience, and I will keep doing it until he is consistently showing up that way. And then I'll up the game a little bit, right? So this is the fast way to start getting what you want. I've never seen results like this with any law of attraction stuff. I have never seen results like this with all the other videos I used to talk about. And I deleted almost all of them, because to me, I don't even want to put that shit out there, because it just keeps people stuck in the fucking loop that I was stuck in, that most of us are stuck in when we start this whole journey. And I was stuck in this thing for over a decade about law of attraction. So I'm only talking about this, because your thoughts create, and all you have to do is focus on what you want and reaffirm it every day more than you don't. And it will manifest. It has to. That is what law of assumption is. You're creating your reality with your consciousness. So your SP is only, if you want to say hearing, you can say that, whatever way makes sense for you. Like, whatever you're focused on in your mind about them and you is what they're receiving, it, because they're not separate from you. So if they're you pushed out, then how you feel about them and think about them and what you perceive about how they view you and feel about you, well, then they have to, they're receiving that. And then that's what they will think and feel as well. So you hold all the power. Use it wisely. That's all I got for today. So I will see you in the next video. Bye.